afternoon. How your baby daddy, your sister, and your cousin and I'm doing? And your hubby too. How y'all living, fam? It is Monday up in this motherfucker, okay? And yeah, y'all, we're just out in these streets after the longest week ever, but the most amazing week ever, okay? And I am groggy, I am tired, I am bigger, I am pregnant, I am stuffy, so you'll hear me a lot, okay? Juice too, allergies, you know how it goes. But I'm just so blessed and so happy. This week was absolutely fucking amazing. We had a wonderful doctor's appointment. The maternity shoot went off without a hitch, as far as I know. I haven't seen the photos yet. They're coming. I promise I will show you guys. The baby shower was epic. Like, y'all, there's a reason that I specifically told everyone that it needed to be an adult shower, because there was just no way we could have kids there or anybody underage there. It was literally exactly what we wanted. The cakes were phenomenal. Like, if you guys haven't seen the footage from it, it's yesterday's vlog, because I've skipped a couple days of vlogging just to kind of give myself a little bit of reprieve and get some rest, which I still seriously need some rest. I haven't been sleeping real well. We've been going to bed 3-4 in the morning because Trey and Juice and I will be up late shooting the breeze and shooting the shit and laughing our asses off, and then get up first thing in the morning. And you guys already know I don't sleep through the night because I get up and have to go to the bathroom all the time. But when I say this was the most epic week ever, and we got through it, because I know everyone was very nervous about how much we had going on, and I think people were kind of nervous, oh my god, are you going to be able to handle it, are you going to be able to make it, you know what I mean? But we did really well and knocked out all of everything. We have diapers galore, okay, because that was, I guess, a requirement for everyone who came to the baby shower to bring a box or a bag or something of diapers, so that helps with us, you know, getting a good start on everything. And it was just so amazing to see everybody. I managed to get off a couple of surprises off to Juice for his B-Day. One you guys saw clearly did not work out, the cake. If I remember to, I will try to, I might put it in the video. It literally collapsed, fell apart. It was fucked up as hell. And you know what? Literally, they were all petrified of calling me to tell me that it was totally destroyed. But to be real, the minute I picked the cake up, the minute I ordered the cake, even 2 months ago, I had a funny feeling the cake wasn't gonna work out. That something was gonna happen to the cake somehow on the way, en route to Jessica's house. And anyway, he was still loving the fact that we even went through the effort, or that I went through the effort to get that for him. Real quick, just FYI, you will see the epic cake fail later on in this video, so just wait on it. It was all good. So the next day was his birthday, which I didn't vlog that day because we really just wanted to spend time together, and it was really just me, Trey, and Juice really most of the day hanging out. And then later on last night, which was yesterday was his birthday, and we hung out. We went to eat with my sister Tosh, which was a surprise to me from Juice, and my mom. We just gossiped the whole damn time about whatever happened over the weekend, which I certainly needed after the week and how crazy it's been. It was just a great and amazing week. It was amazing. It was absolutely amazing, and we got through it, and now we're back in the new week. I just dropped my sister off at the airport. I'm sad. I always get really sad. I usually cry when she leaves. I didn't cry this time, but I bawled when, you know, you guys would have seen the surprise and how I responded to her coming. But it was like the icing on the cake to have her here, because she was the only other person that could not make the shower and couldn't make the festivities. So when I say it's just been an amazing week, it's been an amazing week, okay? Anyway, enough of that. If you guys want to see everything that happened for the showers, the crazy surprises during the showers and before the showers and everything, the maternity shoot, all that stuff, those are the last few vlogs that are right before this video that you're watching right here, okay? So check out the last few vlogs. You'll be able to catch up on everything, all right? Anyway, that being said, it is, I don't even know what time, probably maybe 3 or 3:30 or something like that in the afternoon. This is the first time I picked up the camera in a couple of days. I wanted to take a little break after the showers, or after the shower. And I'm over here at Target. Just got done with Whole Foods. Went to go pick up some fresh fish and pick up my usual watermelon and fruits, you know, all my other things, pineapple, all that shit, and a couple of sparkling, they have like a sparkling Italian soda that we like there. And then I came over here to Target to do a little grocery shopping because I got a gift card, so I was like, well, why not use it to get the few groceries that we need? So just kind of planning out the week's dinners because we ate so badly and poorly this week, and we've been out to eat so many times this week. I'm like, we absolutely positively need to eat in. So I'm kind of planning in my head out the things I'm going to make throughout the week. Plus, I have the glucose test coming up, and I'm just like, I really don't want to take that, and I don't want to fail that either. So I'm like really being cautious about what I'm putting in my body for the next couple of weeks. I mean, I'm going to eat my normal foods and stuff like that, but I'm going to kind of watch what I eat sugar-wise. I know everyone's going to have something to say. By the time you guys see this video anyway, it'll be past tense, okay? But the reality is that test scares the shit out of me for some whatever reason. And for those of you guys who don't know what it is, it's basically the test where you test to see if you have gestational diabetes. And I have to take it sometime before week 28. So anyway, I'm gonna be taking that sometime with between now and this coming week before I hit week 28, okay? So Thursday, because today's Monday, Thursday is week 27 for me. We're in that week right now. So I want to make sure we're eating at home. I'm drinking a lot of water. I'm always drinking a lot of water, but that we eat at home and that I'm not eating a lot of, you know, unnatural sweets and blah, blah, blah. So anyway, and then we're going back to the gym. Probably eat. Well, we may not go tonight. Probably mañana. Mañana we'll get back in the gym, and James and I are going to meet up, and we're going to get some other things done for the work that's being done and blah, blah, blah. So I just want to catch you guys up. But my sister got me hip to this while she was here. Veggie straws. So daggone good. And these are like the individually wrapped ones or whatever. So I can kind of just stick them in my purse for a snack, so I'm not eating anything bad when I'm out and about. For some reason during my pregnancy, I've always loved mac and cheese, like the standard Kraft mac and cheese. And I can eat an entire box myself. I've always been like that. Y'all don't see me eat a lot of pasta, but you're gonna see pasta in here for real. But usual snack stuff I have to put in my purse so that I can have something to eat. I really can't figure out what I'm in the mood to eat, and that's always been the kind of the case throughout this pregnancy. So I'm just kind of grabbing things, like if I have a salty craving, things like that. So some pretzels and things like that. Penne pasta, because I plan to make, and I know you're gonna say the glucose test, don't eat a lot of carbs. I know, I'm not gonna do it when I'm about to take the test. This is just like for this week, and then as I get closer to when I'm gonna go in to get the test taken, I'm going to wean off all that shit and eat more, you know, eat a little bit of protein, you know, eat a little bit cleaner, because I don't wanna take no chances. If I can avoid it, I'm gonna avoid it, you know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, I'm gonna do like a pesto Alfredo type pasta. You guys have seen me do it before, and then I'll probably make some form of taco dinner one night. And then I've got my shiitake tofu noodles at home. I have tons of those, but I also got some regular spaghetti for juice in case, you know, we decide to both have it, or he decides to have it because it's not filling enough for him to have the tofu noodles. And then I got some pasta sauces and whatnot, so I'm gonna do like a red sauce pasta probably sometime this week, and then the white sauce pasta maybe the following week, something like that. Nothing worse. It's not gonna be, trust me, it looks like there's a lot of pasta, but I mean there is, but there's gonna be meats as well because I went and got stuff at Whole Foods already. I got some fish and shrimp and all that kind of stuff. Anyway, okay, so what am I here for? What am I down this aisle for? Oh, I need like sour cream and all that stuff for tacos and cheese. And then I'm gonna get like some of my little frozen meals because they're just easy for me to kind of put in the microwave real quick so that I can get work done when juice isn't home. But other than that, y'all, it's been just amazing. And the gifts that we got were amazing. But you know, all of this that's going on in my nose is not amazing. So we're gonna be just taking vitamin C galore in hopes that this shit is gone soon. Cause I don't think I can take this shit tomorrow, to be real. You're gonna laugh at my favorite meal, but these frozen meals, if you ever get the smart ones, I always get the fish and chips. So good, so fucking good. Anyway, so I always get a couple of those to put in the freezer and I eat that usually. And they always seem to be almost gone when I get them. Let me know if any of you guys have had them. They're good. I mean, for some reason, I like it. So, yeah. But yeah, y'all, Juice should be home in the next couple of hours. And like I said, we are gonna be hitting that gym this week as we usually do. Probably not today, just because I feel kind of groggy and I feel like I need more sleep. And I'm sure Juice is gonna feel probably the exact same way. So, yeah, November 21st. Make sure that this is, yeah. So yeah, we're probably gonna just take it easy tonight. And then tomorrow will be a regular day where we go to the gym and do whatever we have to do. I'm meeting up with James. We're gonna get some stuff done for the bathrooms. You guys know we're doing the bedroom. So we gotta get a move on all of those things. And I'm trying to find the shoes I need. Hold on 1 second. And I'm back. but yeah, y'all. Yeah, Juice should be home any minute. What I'm gonna do tonight, my plan is at least, I wanted to make us some fish. I got us some shrimp cocktail. Y'all know he loves shrimp cocktail, so I was gonna get some fresh shrimp cocktail. Make us some fish. Probably have a salad with it. I got some sparkling apple cider, since we can't have wine, or I can't have wine, excuse me. He can have wine though, but I, you know, he promised me he would drink our favorite wine in front of me, so I don't even have it in the house right now. But yeah, sparkling apple cider and that kind of thing. Just want to do something kind of, you know, nice for him. Just a nice dinner, just because yesterday, even though it was his birthday and we celebrated every, you know, bit of his birthday over the weekend, it just wasn't, you know, this is, you know, because everyone was here, you know what I'm saying? I didn't get to have a chance to have that one-on-one type action with him. So, and because the cake got fucked up, you know, and it wasn't their fault. It was literally because no one had a fridge the size enough to be able to put the cake in so that it could stay together, if that makes sense. So I want to make him a little something for dinner tonight, but healthy, you know what I mean? So we're not, because we were both like, okay, we're done eating like this, we can't do it anymore. So so yeah, that's what the intention is. So we'll kind of have like a little mini B-day type of dinner for my man, and that's what we're gonna do. So go ahead and get everything I need to get from out of here, and I will see y'all on the flip side. I'll see y'all back at the crib. So I'm waiting to check out, and I'm over here in the little magazine section. Something that I am experiencing right now that maybe many of you guys that are preggo or that have been preggo have experienced or are experiencing is the fact that your girl is tired of wearing maternity clothes. And when I say that, I mean, because I didn't go ham and buy shit tons of maternity clothes, there's only so few shirts that I have, so many shirts really I should say, that I have. And so I'm constantly rewashing things, and I feel like I'm rewearing stuff all the fucking time. Y'all see me in stripes all the time because that's all you wear, that's all you wear with maternity. Like this shirt, you know, and those types of things are comfortable. Don't get me wrong, that's the best thing about maternity, is that they're extremely comfortable. When I say you get tired of just putting those on sometimes, because that's really all the options that you have, because none of the things that you would normally wear fit anymore. Oh my goodness, like I just cannot wait to a certain extent, because like I said, maternity is comfortable as hell. It's more comfortable than wearing my own clothes, you know what I mean? But I'm not even gonna lie to you when I say that I can't wait to be able to wear some of my clothes again, you know? But I imagine that my experience with maternity will probably be better in the fall here shortly, because it'll be cooler and I can wear, you know, big sweaters and leggings and things that are super uber comfortable. I think I'm just tired of wearing my summer shirts, because that's all I've been wearing. And like I said, I didn't go ape when I went shopping for summer clothes for maternity, because it's so expensive anyway and I'm only gonna wear them for one summer. So anyway, the reason why I brought that up is because magazines like this that I usually gravitate towards, Style Watch and People Style or whatever, I think that's People Style or whatever, I don't even look at it anymore, because I'm like, it doesn't apply to me right now, because even after the babies are born, I'm gonna have to still get on my snapback, and it's gonna be a little while. Oh, I already started to put stuff on here, but yeah, no, but I thank you very much. If I had, I'd be like, yes, and if I wasn't like this, I'd be like, yes. Thank you. But yeah, so I imagine fall and winter will be, not better, because I'll be bigger and more comfortable and all that, but at least more uncomfortable, that's what I mean to say. But
I'm going to need your driver's license for the
oh, there's no liquor in those. It's not wine, it's apple cider. Yeah, I'm pregnant, I can't even have it anyway. But yeah, So yeah, I'm just tired of wearing my summer pregnancy shirts. I'm gonna be saying the opposite of this next year, because I'll be like, I miss my pregnancy wear because it was so comfortable. I didn't have to worry about sucking in my stomach, and you know what I mean? But for right now, I'm having a moment where I just really, anyway. All right, let me do all my shopping and get my butt home. Okay, just got home, trying to empty out the car, right? And yeah, I just wanted y'all to see the mound of Pampers. Some of these are wipes. Like, I think these are wipes. It's like a box of wipes. Many of you guys were like, hey, whenever you guys go to the store, just pick up a bag of diapers, get various sizes and whatnot. So one of the requirements, as I told you guys earlier, for the shower was that each person brought a box of Pampers. So we got Pampers galore. Of course, like I said, there's some that are wipes over here. So it was really cool. A lot of people who brought Pampers or brought any, you know, diapers. I keep saying Pampers because I'm used to it. But a lot of people who brought diapers also brought wipes along with the diapers, which I thought was really sweet. So we've got a lot of these types of wipes. And then things like this where we have, you know, the multi-pack of wipes that we can use and that kind of thing. So that's really, really cool. I meant to go buy my box today because I know there are some packages there as well. Some of you guys have been sending us gifts for the kiddos. I've got a few people that have been asking if it's too late to send us anything, and if, absolutely, of course not. I kind of said a deadline of the end of the month or end of September, you know what I mean? So, because we wanted to do that virtual shower or whatever at the beginning of October. The baby registry is down below in the description box, but you don't have to do anything on there if you don't want to, or you don't have to get anything on there if you don't want to. You can send whatever you want, you know what I mean? I know some of you guys have ideas of fun things to send the kiddos. So my mailing address is down in the description box as well if you guys want to send us anything. And of course we'll accept things after September, after the end of September. But we're gonna do our virtual shower for you guys in October. So yeah, anyway, I was getting some comments on my Instagram today about that, so I thought I'd address it. Yeah, and then we also have just a few other items here that they're on the floor, but they're going to be washed. Obviously, we have to wash all the clothes before we actually put them in the baby drawers and stuff. So anyway, but yeah, this is just crazy to me. And it's so crazy because this is probably nowhere near the number of diapers that we're going to need for these babies. So anyway, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and finish emptying out this car. And then you should be home any minute. And I'll probably start dinner here relatively early because I'm actually hungry. What up, y'all? Look, had to put the camera on the tripod. Just giving y'all a heads up, your girl's feeling extremely groggy. Had to send Juice out to Walgreens. Say what's up to baby daddy over here.
What up, y'all? What up? What up? What up?
We're struggling, I'm not gonna lie. We're on the struggle bus today. Yeah. Both of our voices are shot. We are exhausted, and I feel like I'm getting sick, and y'all know how that goes when you're preggo, or at least when I've been preggo. It hasn't been a fun experience, so first thing in the morning, I'm calling the doctor.
We gotta make sure she stays from getting sick. Mm-hmm. I mean,
we both have to keep from getting sick.
Especially her, because the doctor's playing to her if she gets sick, and if what if medicine doesn't work, and she's in the ICU, and this and this and that. We're gonna cut that off right there, because we don't wanna have all that, so we're gonna go ahead and try to keep her better.
Yeah.
Keep her getting keep injecting her with vitamin C and all that good stuff.
Mm-hmm. I've been taking my vitamins religiously.
But you gotta get some sleep.
Yeah.
You just sleep for about 12 hours.
I wish it was that easy. Yeah, these twins don't let me do that. But, you know, I had him grab me some nasal spray because my was really congested, and then he got me some all things that I can take. I had to double check and make sure that it was on my list of medicines that I can take as a pregnant woman. And the doctor gave me a list of medicine brands that I can take that are safe for the baby. So I'm very religious about it. They're never as effective as anything that I would have taken being a non-pregnant woman. So just FYI for those of you guys that are gonna be pregnant or that are looking to get pregnant or whatever, just, or that are in the early stages of pregnancy, just know that you're not gonna be able to take the medicines you're accustomed to taking. Like, obviously you can't take Advil, things like that, you know? But I will do whatever I need to do to make sure my babies are protected. So this is what it is. But I did use the nasal stuff, feeling a little bit better. My throat's kind of bothered. It could be because of the drainage though too, so I'm hoping it's not anything worse than that. And I'm hoping to catch some sleep tonight too. Oh, it's a bottle.
I know it's a bottle, but what's it for?
Oh, no, it must have been a card that they were going to write on.
Okay, yeah. And let me try not throwing anything away that we need.
Yeah. So, yeah, y'all, I showed y'all the diapers and stuff like that. Yeah, and that's not even anywhere near the number that we need.
I just been emptying out the kitchen today and trying to get the living room straight. Trying to separate the trash from all the gifts and everything, so. Hopefully, we'll get all this room emptied out by this weekend. And, definitely got some organizing new in the basement. And, we got some, what's this?
This is a shrimp cocktail cake. And some crab cakes.
I know what this is.
Yeah, he loves some shrimp cocktail. Yeah. That's why they had it at the show. I don't even know if y'all saw it before everybody ate it. Did you show any food? Did you show the food when you were flung?
I don't even know.
It was the most turnt, y'all know, the most turnt shower you have ever seen in your life, probably.
Yeah, Manishka and Jess fixed me a plate of shrimp cocktail, though. A big one.
Yeah, man, that's his absolute favorite, okay?
It's not favorite, but you know.
He loves it. Yeah. This time, though, hold up. What do you think I got besides that?
Some fish?
No, I mean, yeah, which is in the oven.
Dijon?
Bam!
What's that?
Horseradish. Ever since I had it at that restaurant at the lake, I have been obsessed with horseradish with the shrimp cocktail or in the cocktail sauce. Mm-hmm. You kind of just mix it in a little bit, gives it a little extra kick for some reason. I've been obsessing over it. Hold on. Right back. Hold on.
It's all right.
Oh, it's so good.
It's all right, y'all. It ain't the best thing you're going to ever have, but it's all right. You know, you guys like horseradish.
It's delicious. It's from Trader Joe's. I mean, Whole Foods.
It's an acquired taste, okay? For me, the cocktail sauce is enough, and shrimp is definitely enough. Is it frozen or is this?
No. It's refrigerated. Okay, so cool. We're good. But yeah, I just wanted y'all know to treat Juice to a little.
Good.
Little, you know, good. Something since the cake didn't work out. You know what I mean?
Don't worry about the cake.
I know. He's been like, don't worry about the cake. It's no big deal. And everything else was gorgeous and beautiful.
We enjoyed ourselves. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, we had a great, I mean, it was, the shower was phenomenal. We had a great, great time. What's up, y'all? Okay. Real quick, wanted to pop in. I know it's in the middle of the vlog or whatever, but I wanted to pop in because I'm editing said vlog to show you guys what happened with the cake. I think I referenced it a couple of times earlier in the video. I hope I got everything as far as the video clips in sync. I am still sick as a dog. When y'all are watching this video right here, that was when I first started to feel sick, and I've been sick for days now, which is why there's been a delay in the vlogs. As you guys know, obviously, I do all the editing myself, so just be patient with me as I get caught up, but stay tuned to this channel because there will be more vlogs coming, and then you guys can finally see what's been going on and why life has been so hectic, because it has been cray-cray since the shower and all of that good shit. I also wanted to say thank you guys so much for the amazing and beautiful and loving comments you guys left on the baby shower footage from the other day. It was an amazing, amazing event, and it meant a shit ton to both Juice and I. So I'm so glad you guys enjoyed it and were able to live vicariously through the footage. But the reason why I wanted to pop in is because I've mentioned in this video a couple of times that, and some previous videos, that I tried to surprise Juice with something else, and I never really showed you guys what it was. Now, I know some of y'all get frustrated when I don't show y'all right away whatever surprise or whatever the fuck it is I'm trying to show y'all. And, I mean, y'all gotta allow me some time to surprise y'all too, okay? So, there's times I may not show y'all something, but that doesn't mean I'm never gonna show y'all. It just means I'm gonna do a reveal of some sort for whatever that is, i.e. my maternity shoot photo. I might give you a tease or two, but you'll see the photos eventually, okay? So just be patient with me. But in this particular case, I went and picked up one of Juice's surprises, which was something I'd been working on for 2+ months, which I can now tell you was an amazingly beautiful cake that I had made for his birthday. You guys know his obsession with Star Wars. And what ended up happening is, and the reason why you guys never saw it is, one, when I got it, when I first picked it up, as you guys saw the footage, it was wrapped. You would have never seen what the cake looked like, and it was wrapped specially so that they only wanted really for you to take it out the box when it was time to serve the cake, to be completely real, which is why I didn't show it to you guys, because all you got would have seen was a box, okay? So it wasn't because I was trying to be a jerk off. It was because it was in a box and you wouldn't have seen what the cake looked like. So I assumed when I revealed the cake at the shower, which was the intent, that I would have been able to show y'all what it looked like. Well, as you guys know, a fiasco happened with the cake, which is why you never saw the cake. It wasn't because I was just trying to hold off and do all that or whatever. It was boxed up in a way where you guys couldn't have seen it. So just trust, your girl always shows you guys the stuff that I refer to. But you gotta let me have a little bit of fun too. I mean, come on. Like the nursery, I'm gonna do a reveal. Y'all know I'm gonna do that. Y'all may see, trust me, there's vlogs coming up where you're gonna see how chaotic it is in this house. But let me have a little fun with y'all a little bit so y'all can see the final results of the things that we do and that kind of thing. But trust and believe, you guys are gonna see footage and that type of thing along the way. Cause I know I got a few comments that were like, why didn't you show us? Why didn't you show us? Now you know why, okay? Let me show you what the cake originally looked like and what it looked like when I picked it up from the cake place, okay? And this thing, thank God I have a picture, so hold up one second. So this is what the cake looked like, okay? As you guys can see, it was freaking phenomenal. And it was Star Wars themed, so of course, you know, we've got Yoda, we've got Chewbacca, you know what I'm saying. So it was phenomenal. This cake was absolutely phenomenal and it tasted freaking amazing. So now I'm gonna insert the footage of when I finally showed Juice what the cake looked like after what happened to the cake. And basically what happened is no one had a fridge large enough to house the cake that we had, in addition to the two cakes you guys saw at my baby shower. I actually picked out my own cakes for my baby shower. I wanted a girl cake and a boy cake, and I wanted it to be a king and queen or prince and princess themed baby shower. So everything you guys saw was basically kind of the brainchild of myself, and my friends, especially Jess, really stepped up and just made everything absolutely amazing. So anyway, in addition to the cakes that they had to refrigerate, those two, they had to also essentially refrigerate that because I was trying to hide it from Juice and there was just no room. My sister took the cake from me when I gave it to her and she didn't put it in the fridge and they didn't have enough room anyway. So I had a funny feeling when I picked the cake up, it was not gonna make it there in one piece, and it did not. So I ended up showing Juice what the cake ended up looking like after when they brought it over, and it completely collapsed because it needed to have been in the fridge. So that's pretty much what happened. I'm gonna show you guys the footage or insert the footage here, and then we'll continue on with the rest of the vlog. But wanted to pop in and make sure that I shared that with you guys. I didn't wanna put it in the baby shower footage because I'm actually gonna keep, obviously I keep memorable moments all together. And you know, I tried to save those moments and I didn't wanna have that be one of those for the baby shower as a memory, even though it was a memory. So I kind of save the footage to share with you guys in this video because I wanted it to just be baby footage and everything that went off well with no hiccups, and then I knew I would share it with you guys somewhere in this video. So anyway, check out the footage of me showing Juice what the cake looked like. You'll see how bad it looks. I actually wasn't upset. Excuse me. I wasn't upset when they called to tell me that it had collapsed because I had a funny feeling when I picked the cake up, it wasn't going to make it there. So it is all good. Everything else went off without a hitch. His surprise, Ashley, all of that went off without a hitch. And we had a great birthday the next day. So I wanted to make sure I popped in and told you all that. So anyway, enjoy the footage and enjoy the rest of the vlog. All right. Okay, so we kind of had another surprise for you, but we had an unfortunate mishap. Okay, come, just follow. Do you know where it is?
Where is it? Kind of like that.
Do you know where it is? Do you know where it is? Okay. Where is it? Do you know?
I don't know.
I think it's under. See? Okay, y'all.
It was like so fly earlier.
Okay, it was a whole cake.
I get
it had it was Chewbacca. Yoda was here, and
that.
Then this was on top, and then it fell the hell apart.
I get the idea.
It's so good too.
Cindy,
yeah.
This is the other layer.
Yeah.
Okay.
It fell apart.
It is so good.
It just was warm today, but it's good. Yeah.
Yeah.
What kind of cake is it? It's like an almond flavor.
Yeah, almond, yep.
It's so good.
But you see this like Star Wars cake on deck?
Yeah, I'm gonna show you what it looked like originally.
No.
I'll show you a picture of what it looked like originally.
Man, it's like we're hungover. Like, I'm hungover. Like, I'm hungover. He's probably legitimately hungover.
Tired, shit.
Cause he was tart, y'all.
probably saw. Okay, let's see here. Let me try to see if I can mix this up.
Yeah.
See how it tastes? What? Mm. So I got some cod.
Oh, you did?
Yup. Okay. And yeah, I got some cod. That's what's in the oven right now. So when it comes out, I'll show you guys. And then I got some crab cakes. I'm gonna go ahead and sear those.
Yeah, some quick and easy.
Yep, and then shrimp cocktail. Mm. Oh, I love horseradish. Mm. Oh my God, that's so good with horseradish. Hey.
Horseradish opens you up.
Mm-hmm. Which is good for me.
Right, for your sinuses. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So you mix the little shrimp cocktail sauce, or cocktail sauce. It doesn't even look appealing. I would have never put the two together. Not for real. And I had it at the lake, and that's all I've ever wanted is horseradish with my cocktail sauce. So I've got it so I can have some here at all times. Look, we're grubbing. As you can tell, we're low energy, and we apologize. But, oh my God, that's so good. Hold up. Are you grubbing? You enjoying yourself? You already ate damn near half of this already. No, I only had one Negro.
We almost ate half this.
I had one. This is two.
We.
Y'all see how quick he's going through this? Oh my God, so good. Anyway, y'all want to see us just eat shrimp cocktail. I'm gonna make the crab cakes.
Okay.
But opening that one.
Yeah, I got it.
Now I get the pan. We have a nice, delicious seafood dinner. Mm-hmm. Shut up, Juice. Shut it up. I know what you just did. Damn it. Do we have a smaller pan of these, honey?
Yeah.
Just kidding. Mm-hmm. Jesus. Anyway, we're gonna go ahead and continue to eat this. And then I'll show you guys what everything looks like when it's all done. Done. I can't talk. I'm sorry, I'm sick.
Hey, struggle bus at work today, y'all. Struggle bus.
How was work, by the way?
Work was work, you know.
Oh, we did get the new microwave, just FYI. I don't know if you guys even noticed.
I lost my voice. I took 2 cups of coffee for it to come back this morning.
For real?
But I made it. Now I'm back here.
Mm-hmm.
After a while, this shit got a kick to it after a while.
What? The cocktail sauce.
Cocktail sauce.
There's nothing like that in there.
Oh, it seems up on you.
Mm-hmm.
If you eat it as fast as I'm eating it.
Nah, you're just a wuss.
Sooner or later.
You're just a wuss, that's
it
all.
It sneaks up on you.
Oh, you know what? I should probably use a bigger pan. I'm gonna go ahead and just cook both of these. Don't you think?
Spray that stuff in the pan.
Huh?
Don't spray that stuff in the pan and just put it aside, huh?
I did not mean to. Alright, so we're gonna do this. We're gonna do it.
We're gonna do it.
Oh my God.
All right.
Alright. Anyway, we're gonna let y'all go. We'll show you what the finished product looks like. Okay, so want to make sure that I showed you guys all the rest of the fixins because I'm making the crab cakes. This is the very first time that I've made crab cakes. I think I might have made them in the oven, like the frozen kind from Sam's or some shit, but this is the first time that I've seared crab cakes before. And these are actually from Whole Foods, and I've been wanting to try them for the longest time, and I went ahead and tried them out this time, right? So that's what I'm searing. I'm browning both sides, right? I'm browning them for a few minutes on each side. The crab meat's already cooked. So I'm gonna probably go ahead and check the other side and make sure it's browned enough. Yes, yes, honey. And I'm a lefty and I'm doing this right-handed because I'm holding y'all. But anyway, all right, so we got this. Take a look at how nice and brown that is. Yes, okay. Then we got the cod, all right. All my seasonings and everything on that. Y'all know I'm a seasoning person, so I put a whole hell of a lot of stuff on my fish, or any meat for that matter. So we had the shrimp cocktail, y'all know about the crab cakes, got the cod, and then, oh, it's in the freezer, I just put it in the freezer a little bit ago to keep it super cold. We got this right here, Martinelli's sparkling cider. I figured have a little some, you know, a little bubbly or something. Non-alcoholic, of course. And you know, that type of thing. And then I also have a Caesar salad that I need to go ahead and take out so I can toss it. So I'm gonna go ahead and toss this salad. We're not gonna be doing that type of tossing. Cause I ain't in the mood for that shit tonight. I mean, I ain't never been in the mood for that. I mean, I don't know, too early. Okay, yeah, we're back to this. So, got ourselves some Caesar salad that I'm gonna go ahead and toss real quick. And that's pretty much what it's gonna be for Din Din. So, I'm excited. The crab cakes smell amazing. The kitchen, generally speaking, smells amazing. And yeah, I hope you like the meal. I don't know, I felt like with the cake having been ruined and everything, I had to do something, you know what I mean? Granted, he's been saying, don't worry about it. Don't worry about my birthday this year. And he got to celebrate this weekend. He turned up both nights, got to be around his friends and family and all that good stuff, but I wanted something for me, you know what I mean? Ugh, and that cake, even though I took it like a champ when they told me that it was ruined, because I was just like, you know what, I'm just happy he's here. And this is what he's always wanted. He's always wanted to be a daddy. And so I'm giving him the best gifts he could possibly ask for, okay? But I still wanted to give him something, you know? So, I'll go ahead and mess with these crab cakes. Got some lemon I'm gonna go ahead and cut up, and I'll show you guys everything when it's all finished.
All right, y'all, so the fish just came out the oven.
Give her.
It looks beautiful, y'all, check it out.
Doesn't this look amazing, babe?
Mm-hmm. Looks good.
Yes.
Looks delicious. And then we got the Caesar salad going on right here.
Yep.
And we got the crab cakes and limones.
Yes, yes, yes. We're going to put the fish and salad right there.
Mm-hmm. Looking good. Looking good. We'll top it all off. We got some non-alcoholic sparkling cider for those of y'all that have never tasted this before. It's actually delicious. But yeah. Fish came out great. Where'd you get that from today?
Whole Foods, actually.
Babe. Okay, okay. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that.
I'm gonna go ahead and put that right over here.
Yeah, yeah, looks good.
For you?
Yeah, look. I'm gonna do nice. Show them how flaky it looks. Yeah.
Isn't that fucking amazing? Look at that.
Came out nice.
Yes.
Go
ahead.
How long did you cook that?
About 25 minutes.
25 minutes?
I like to make sure that it's completely cooked all the way through.
Okay.
Just because I'm a paranoid person, but.
Fish and crab cakes.
Yes.
And salad.
And then I also have.
Uh-oh.
Let's see if I can find it.
Uh-oh, y'all.
We've got two other sides for the fish.
Okay.
Okay, so we've got the Cajun stuff, remoulade, whatever.
Okay, I'm gonna let you eat
and
that.
Lemon
one.
Dill tartar. That's probably what you're gonna go
I'm
for.
Go with that one. That's me.
This is good, but it has kick to it. So I actually got him the lemon dill.
Are you supposed to be eating a lot of spicy stuff?
Oh no, that's not heavily spicy. I can't do super spicy at all.
Mm-hmm.
No super spicy. I'm positive. So I'll put a little bit of the lemon dill tartar on your plate, sir. You have to let me know with the crab cake. With the crab.
Let me get that for you.
Yes, please. Try not to break any nails, y'all, because I ain't trying to go to no more nail salons to do no more shit.
Yes.
Okay?
There you go.
There you go.
Yeah, we gonna ban you from nail salons from now on.
There you go.
We gonna ban you from the things.
Man. For real?
Yeah? How much money y'all think y'all spend on nails?
Oh my God.
Well, what's up with that trend?
Whatever. Here we go.
Oh yeah, look at that.
And boom. Mm-hmm. For you?
Yeah. That'll work.
I'm gonna do a side of that and.
Mm-hmm. You wanna squeeze a lemon on them? I'll do that when I stab.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I don't know how much lemon you want on yours, but I'm gonna do both the.
Looks good. It's looking good.
And stuff.
Looking good. See the difference.
Boom.
Okay.
Boom.
You can definitely tell what's Cajun and what's not.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't leave much room for the salad, but we can put it right over here.
Oh, don't worry. Don't worry about that.
The lemon we'll just
squeeze it in on the corner right there.
Right over here. So I'll go ahead and serve your salad.
Mm-hmm. It should be good. All right, y'all. I think it's time for us to eat.
And here it is. For you, sir. For your birthdays.
This is the makeup for the cake.
Yeah, man. Y'all don't even want to know how much that cake costs, but
not gonna talk about that, man. We just look at the food. I got over it though, kinda.
Kinda, y'all. She's still salty about it.
But that's all right. That's all right. That's all right. I had a feeling that was gonna happen. But anyway, I'm exhausted, y'all.
Yeah, she needs to get some rest tonight, so.
I'm pooped.
We're gonna definitely put her down for at least 12 hours tonight, y'all. So we're gonna grub on this food, drink some sparkling cider, and watch some TVs.
Yep.
So, yeah. We're gonna holler at y'all. Manana. All right.
Love y'all. Thumbs up the video, subscribe if you haven't already, and we love y'all. We'll see y'all tomorrow.
All right,
y'all. Bye. Peace.